This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Vacancies on Newbury Street.
13-14%.
Dead malls on Facebook.
It can be depressing at times.
And now L.L. Bean won't take back your 20-year-old boots.
The lifers now presumably feel like they've been robbed.
What is going on? Why are shopping centers de-malling?
I think the word mall has a stigma.
And clicks turning to bricks for online sellers.
We've really found our customers shop with their hands.
Rewriting the rules of retail, next on Chronicle.
Good evening. We all know traditional retailers are challenged on all sides by online merchants and discounters.
Tonight, we'll see how they are fighting back and what it all means for consumers, beginning with returns.
We've all done it at some point. We make a purchase and it doesn't quite fit or fails to work the way we intended. Back to the store it goes for a full refund. But for retailers, it's a different story. According to a retail research firm, shoppers returned $643 billion worth of merchandise worldwide in 2015, with reasons ranging from defects or poor quality to wrong sizing, buyer's remorse, and even fraud. That's why certain retailers are cracking down on those who abuse their generous return policies. L.L. Bean made news recently when it gave the boot to its long-standing satisfaction guarantee, a decision made by competitor REI in 2013. L.L. Bean had previously accepted returns on any product ever sold, regardless of the item's age or condition. But in the last 5 years, abusive or fraudulent returns have cost the Freeport, Maine company $250 million. From now on, returns will only be accepted if they were purchased within the last 12 months or have a manufacturing defect.
L.L. Bean told us they continue to stand behind the products they sell, and the return policy has simply been adapted to reflect its intent. It was never meant to be a lifetime replacement policy.
Scott Commoners is an associate professor at Harvard Business School. He believes L.L. Bean might come to regret changing a policy that has always set their brand apart.
Lots of people would buy because they knew they could have this guarantee, and many of them would then not use it. So it's been a very, very powerful marketing and margin-generating tool for them.
Professor Commoners identifies two groups of customers who might be affected by the change.
People were buying lots and lots of L.L. Bean products at yard sales, and they were, you know, taking them and returning them in bulk. And these are what I would call fraudsters. You know, they're people who aren't actually engaged with the brand or with the company, aren't even wearing the products. They're just acquiring them for the sake of returning them. Meanwhile, the guarantee was, you know, over time and has historically been used a lot by lifers, you know, sort of lifetime brand evangelists who buy L.L. Bean everything, you know, often very outdoorsy, buy it for their children and eventually their grandchildren. And those people use the guarantee to replenish and replace products that they'd used year after year and really loved.
So how will those so-called lifers respond to their favorite brand clamping down on returns?
The lifers now presumably feel like they've been robbed. They have this brand they love. It's almost like a breaking off of a relationship. Meanwhile, the fraudsters will move on, right? They'll go and find some other retail opportunity that they can take advantage of.
Diehard shoppers say it's probably a case of a few bad apples spoiling the barrel.
I just think it's a little bit ridiculous that you can buy something and then years later, if it breaks, return it. It seems a little bit abusive to me of the whole situation.
Certain policies that were once appropriate or beneficial don't always apply over time.
I think my loyalty runs pretty deep. I buy a lot of stuff there, and it would take quite a bit, I think, for me to reverse trends.
The good news for customers, several other companies have no plans to change their policies. Shoppers can still rely on unconditional lifetime guarantees from Eddie Bauer and Patagonia.
Will lifetime warranties eventually disappear altogether? Well, as with everything else in life, there are no guarantees.
Meanwhile, some retailers are really starting to crack down on these serial returners with the help of some third-party companies.
Yes, they track how often that people are making these returns, and if their score is high and if they have a high percentage, then they can actually be banned from a store for a period of time. So,
one solution to an
ongoing
problem.
And I'm guilty of that. I return probably far too much.
Wow, true confessions on Chronicle this evening. How nice. Newbury Street still has that special something.
This is a 15-carat emerald cut diamond, and you certainly will never see this anywhere else in Boston.
But why doesn't it have more stores?